That's the Atlantis, the Palm Hotel. It's on the outer front at the Palm in Dubai. As is this hotel, welcome to the Jumeirah Zabeel Saray Hotel. It's the view from my room, looking at the Palm. Palm in Dubai. Beautiful Sunday morning here. So welcome to Dubai, people, and welcome to the Jumeirah Hotel in Dubai. Yeah, I'll give you a tour of the place. Yeah, so that's the Atlantis Palm. I've stayed there before. That's on the center of the outer front. Palm. Those people are familiar with what the Palm is. See all these expensive houses. I think there's 8 fronts to the Palm. David Beckham's got a house there. The Emirate of Dubai. The beautiful blue waters, beautiful Sunday morning. Persian Arabian Gulf here in Dubai. It's the view from the room. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Hotel has its own private beach, which is just there. If you notice, all the chairs face this way and not the water's way. We'll walk down there, I'll show you that. Which is fair enough, because looking at the hotel down there is actually much nicer than looking out to the water. It's a beautiful view. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray Hotel. Hotels also residences. They're quite expensive, the residences. So there's buildings there. Yeah, so we're on the outer front of the Palm. It's a view from the room. Garden needs a bit of work. It's all right. Get a decent view of the Palm. The Burj Al Arab, it's the most famous hotel. Dubai city center. It's basically in that direction. We're in the Emirate of Dubai. Jebel Ali is the suburb, just sort of over there, past the residences. Alrighty, so room, you get a balcony. So I think it's some deluxe king palm room, palm view room. It's the Palm there. There's one up from the basic room. This is the room that you get here. Jumeirah on home turf. Jumeirah is a hotel chain. And the first one was the Burj and the Jumeirah Beach Hotel. And then, got a few around the world, and I wanted to in Dubai as well. The UAE. It's a room. It's a good room. It's a good hotel. Yeah, that's the place, Jumeirah. So just to orientate ourselves to where we are. So I've got my handy iPhone. We'll go on Google Maps. Yeah, so that's the place. Yeah, we're on the outer palm now. We'll just, that's the one. So that's the Palm in Dubai. That's what it looks like, yeah. That blue dot is me just there. When it zooms, it says the Palm Jumeirah. Yep. Atlantis Palm, the hotel that you saw out there. Just make it a bit smaller. It's Dubai. Straits of Hormuz, Iran. Make it a bit smaller. And you can still see the blue dot. That's where I am. That's Africa, Europe, the Americas, it's around the world, yeah. Antarctica and so on. MH370 is down there somewhere. Alrighty. So that's where we are. Welcome to Dubai. Welcome to the Jumeirah Hotel in Dubai, yeah. Alrighty. So Atlantis, the Palm, I've stayed there before, which is why I'm not staying there today. It's out of front. The inner ones have all got houses. The outer ones are, I think it's for 5-star hotels. Look at some of these houses. It's about 2 or 3 mil US for a house. Maybe a bit more. Nice houses, yeah? I think there's 8 fronts. This is the most outer one. I'll talk to you about the hotels that are on the fronts later. Let's go on our walk. Balcony. Towel as always for the heat. And this is the room that you get here. Yeah, we got it yesterday. Some fruit there. That's where the room's been used for a day. This is that's their spa, Telly's Ottoman spa. The whole hotel is built on the theme of the Turkish Ottoman Empire. Vision, this is like a Dubai magazine. Stuff about Dubai. Keep reinventing themselves every year. That's the Jumeirah magazine. called? Adverts for stuff like that. Best Middle Eastern restaurant, according to BBC. And we've got BBC on the box. Because it's also the best broadcasting service in the world. Yeah, that's the room. Yeah, it's one off the basic room. I want it a palm view because I think it's better than looking at the open ocean. I'll walk you to both sides. And we get there. Right, what else did I want to show you here? Right, let's look at the bathroom. It's just right here. Okay, sports fans. Yeah, the gear is Asprey. Asprey London. Good old quality British stuff. Yeah, it's a room. The bathroom, it's quite a large bathroom actually. I read a review on Twitter for the, you can see through the to the bedroom. I read a review on Twitter, somebody wrote, you can actually go swimming in it. Yeah, if you really want to, that's the shower. Yeah, we're not going to waste unnecessary time here, but sure, the minibar. It's always very important. Fully stocked, no alcohol, because we're in the Middle East. Muslim country. Oh, there is? Yeah, you can get alcohol in five-star hotels here. You can't get it, like... you can't just go to a shopping mall or walk down the street to a pub. And, go to a pub and stuff, but, five-star hotels is okay. A little bit smart like that. All right, so that's the Palm. We'll go for a walk. Yeah, I normally try and make videos on the first day I get here so it doesn't look like this. You know, the bed looks nice. You know what you're getting yourself in for when you check into a hotel. We got in at Emirates. Got in with the boys. Bathroom, nice. Ottoman styling. Yeah, we got in at Emirates yesterday at... we were supposed to get in at 1 o'clock. We actually got in at 5 o'clock. Come on, man. 218. Yeah, we got in at... Plane was supposed to get in at 1 o'clock. We got in at 1:30. Got a total about 3 o'clock. I'd booked to go and do some sightseeing in Dubai Mall. Took the boat on the fountain. Went up Burj Khalifa up at the top. 6 o'clock. Basically dumped the stuff here and went sightseeing straight away. So that's why I get the hotel video on day 2. So this hotel, Jumeirah Zabeel Saray, they say it's all sort of based on Ottoman, Turkish Empire design. The Ottoman Empire went on for about 7 centuries between like, I don't know, 11th to the 18th or something. Yeah, so that's the main thoroughfare from the lobby. Yeah, the Ottoman Empire went until, they say it united the Muslim community all the way from Turkey, the Middle East, North Africa and stuff. And when you're in a Muslim country, I think it's fair enough to design a hotel as such. That's not the reason I stay there, because I'm not Muslim. I think it's a perfectly decent religion. I stay there because it's Jumeirah at the beach. Just working my way down the list. All right, we'll go downstairs to the mezzanine. Yeah, there's your Ottoman design. It's a good hotel. I won't say it's a great hotel. I think it's a good hotel. Alrighty, we'll go to mezzanine. Yeah, I want level 2. That's one of the basic room. Yeah, that's the main walkway from the lobby. It's a nice hotel. Jumeirah, stay different. That's the spa. Apparently it's the largest spa. When we checked in, they said it's the largest spa in the Middle East and Africa. Shops on both sides. That's the main entrance, the centre bit where you see that waterfall. Today is December the 14th. So Christmas is just around the corner. They've got a big Christmas tree in the middle. In a Muslim country. It's lovely to see. We'll walk around there in a bit. I'll look around. The business center's just up here. It's just down there, the business center. Wait for the order for the SketchUp, yep. Business center's just over there. There's no point walking down there. I walked down there earlier, it's a dead end. Yeah, we'll just walk along the mezzanine because you get good views of the main lobby area. You see all the shops down there. I think that's a Lebanese restaurant. Lebanese, Al Nufura. The reflection of Rodeo Drive. It's the main lobby. Just walk along there. Yeah, it's a good hotel. I like it. It's good. It's not the best in Dubai. It's not the best in the world, but it's a nice hotel. Yeah, it's just the main lobby complex. The main entrance of the hotel is just to the left there. You can make out the light Christmas tree. 11 days from Christmas. Main lobby. Reindeer. Santa Claus. Wait, there. Santa Claus on his reindeer. And a Christmas tree and a fountain. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Zahil Saray. That's the bar. It's open till 3 o'clock in the morning. I went there about midnight last night. And people sitting out. It's quite full actually. People sitting out. They're smoking that hashish stuff. Yeah. Sunday morning here. It's just after 10 o'clock in the morning. Right yesterday. It's a bit quiet in the morning. Yeah, you check in just over there on the right. It's a bit there. It's a Christmas theme in Dubai. Just walk along the mezzanine floor to the end. We walk down the stairs. I'll walk you along that walkway. It's nice. Not every hotel in the world is the same. Service is pretty good. They're fairly prompt when you ask them for bucket of ice, can you come and clean the bins? When you order food that's not on the room service menu, and so on. Like prawn curry. Prawn curry is not on the room service menu, but if you want prawn curry, they'll make it for you. Yes, that's the main fountain in the middle. Walk down there. How do you say it? Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Alright, I remember that. Zabeel Saray. Yeah, walk on this corridor. Walk the end and then cut down, take the stairs down. There's various meeting rooms here. Turquoise meeting. So on. There's another restaurant there. Diamond. Alrighty, show you the hotel key card. Looks like that on the one side. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Sarah, Sarah, whatever will be. Alright, so that looks like a steakhouse. Another Christmas tree. It's called the Rib Room. I think it's a steakhouse. Alrighty. Let's go. Stairs down. Let's go to the main lobby. Shops here. There's a restaurant as well. One's called Well, that's the Voda Bar. That one's open till like 3 o'clock in the morning. it's beach access through there. Christmas decorations. Wonderful. I was walking to the lobby, the main bit, center bit, more shops. So this is the fountain in the middle. It's the fountain in the middle of the entrance. Just there. Checkout is just over there. That's what we're doing later today, because we're going to Abu Dhabi this afternoon. Taking the seaplane. Yeah, that's the main entrance. Checkout is the fountain. A Christmas tree in a Muslim country. Very good. Santa Claus and his reindeer. Let's walk to this bar. Yeah, it's lobby bar. That's where you check in. Straight there. Welcome to Dubai. I think it's the world's fastest growing city. Let's check out. So you saw all this from the mezzanine floor upstairs. They say it's Turkish Ottoman design. If I didn't know that, I wouldn't realize, yeah? I would just think it's just another hotel. You know, you can design it how the heck you want to, I don't care. As long as it's nice, decent food, decent bed, safe, good location, that's all that matters. All right, we'll go to the beach. The beach is, hi. Yeah, yeah. Thank you, yep. thank you. It's the wrong card. Yeah, security, it's good. Alright, I don't know if you realise, I just half dropped the camera there. Alright, we're back to head up display. Alrighty. So, just walked outside, it's beachside in the hotel. Saw this from the room. Absolutely beautiful, yeah, it's gorgeous. I forgot to put a towel on the balcony so we could identify my room. The gardens. The rest of the hotel. Absolutely great. I think, at a guess, that's my room. That one there. I'll walk to the beach. We'll walk over the pool. That's the hotel. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Palm in Dubai. So we'll walk down to the beach, go past the pool, and check out the place. So this is all the dining areas of the hotel. So there's a little pool here. Beautiful, yeah. It's like an infinity pool at the Palm. It's my mum there. Hello! Yeah, she's just sitting in the cafe, cappuccino. Bridge. It's in the gardens of the hotel. Nice pool. Yeah, it's a different design, yeah, but it's still nice. I won't knock it. All right, let's walk down to the beachside. The kids' play area just over there. See all those green and yellow colours? It's for kids. A little water sports and stuff. Shallow pools so they don't drown. Hey.
Morning.
Morning. It's called Palm Jumeirah. It's beachside dining area. Plage. Right. Now, one interesting thing you'll see here is all the deck chairs face the hotel. None of them face the water. The hotel obviously has a self-inflated opinion of itself. And people don't even turn the chairs the other way. Just look at the hotel and not the water. When in Rome, I'm not complaining. All right, so this is the Palm in Dubai. You saw that on the Google Maps. You've got Atlantis. The Palm is just out there. That's on the right of the center. And then this, I think it's 8 fronts. You see the houses on each of the fronts there. We're on the west front. West front, the hotel is this Kempinski on this side. You have to drive, when you come here, you have to drive all the way along the center one, and you drive all the way around the loop, so it's a bit of a drive. There's a Kempinski there. They're building a W hotel. I think that might be Kempinski's, no, it's further along. That might be Kempinski. They're building a W hotel and a Taj Exotica on this side. We're at the Jumeirah. There's also a one and only hotel chain, also 5-star. They're further along the coast. On the east, this is the outer front, yeah? On the other side, it's the east side, it's the west side. So the west side, this side is Kempinski, they're building W Taj, Jumeirah, one and only. On the west side, on the east side, it's the other side. There's Sofitel, Anantara, Waldorf Astoria, off the top of my head. Let's go and look at the water. Persian Arabian Gulf. I'm wearing shoes. Alright, get it wet. Screw it up. It's not a proper beach anyway, because it's man-made and inland. Socks are gone now. Alright, so we'll go back inside. Walk out the front. Go back inside, walk out the front. I'll show the so mine's a palm view room. You can also get an ocean view room. It's on the other side, so I'll show you that section of ocean, because it's the Straits of Hormuz. You can just see the top of the birds there. It's the Burj Al Arab and the Burj Khalifa. Excellent. I don't think I'd see that. Burj Al Arab, Burj Khalifa in one frame. Went up the Burj Khalifa yesterday at night. It's quite good. That's the hotel and the infinity pool. Walked over the bridge. Nice Sunday morning. Nice walk on a Sunday morning. People sunbathing, looking at the hotel. I've never seen that before. All right, that is the first ever for me. Yeah. Yeah, the Jumeirah residence is just further along. I think they start at like 10, yeah, they call it Royal Residences. That one there. I looked at the photos when I booked this hotel. I thought I'd stay there for a night. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Stay different. I looked at the prices, yeah, it's like 10,000 dirhams for a night. Conversion rate to UK pounds is 5.6. It's like 2 grand a night. It's Like, Virgil Arab's about just over 1,000. But it's nice. Let's walk into the gardens, walk back into the hotel. And I'll take you out the front. Leisure counter, got towels for the swimming and stuff. That's the bridge we walked over earlier. Saw the pool to the right. Yeah, it's good. It's a good hotel. Not the best in the world. Not the best in Dubai, but it's good. You don't stay in the same place all the time, right? When, check out different places. It's part of exploring the planet. Dining area. Just walk back into the hotel. Cut out the front. Let's get the camera on me as we walk past security here. Walk outside and go to the other side, look at ocean view. Yeah. Hope you like my shirt. When you're on your holiday, you know, you get random shirts. Batik, I think they call it. Lobby, Christmas tree, fountain. Best story I have about shirts. I'll tell you in a minute. That's the main lobby. It's going to walk out the front. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Let's walk out the front. So this is the front entrance. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. I can say it right now. Got these fountains out here. On both sides. Very nice, grand entrance to the hotel. The Christmas tree. That's the main entrance. You see a reflection of me. Good day, boys. Hi. Yeah, that's how you get here. Right, so we'll walk the beach there. So that story about shirts, yeah? When you're on holiday, you wear silly shirts like this, yeah? Hi, hi. Just walking around. Yeah, it's the main entrance. First time ever I went to the Maldives. I got in about, it was a late night, late evening flight. I got in about 10 o'clock in the evening. Speedboat comes to pick you up. So I was just wearing normal clothes, like shorts and a t-shirt. Got in the speedboat, takes to the resort. It was Paradise Island or something, about 20 minutes from the airport. There's an American guy, he got on as well. He was wearing like normal, he was wearing trousers and a like a business shirt. I think he just got off a long haul flight. Sat in front of me on the boat and said, he put on this short sleeve shirt with like big dolphins on it. Said, yeehaw, I'm back in the Maldives. So that's what you do on your holiday, yeah? You wear silly shirts. It's the main entrance. That's Jebel Ali in the suburb of Dubai. Go outside. Walk along the ocean front, as they call it, and I'll walk you to the. There's a sign that says the hotel's name. I'll walk you to there. We'll just have a look at the ocean. So if you get an ocean view room, that's the hotel. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. If you get an ocean view room, that's what you see. A lot less than if you get a Palm View room. I don't think it's much difference in the price. I think it's just personal preference. It's about there. Yeah, you can see the port, various ports in the distance. Uh, I think that's Jebel Ali, suburb in the Emirate of Dubai. Somebody are water skiing there. I tried that once. You need strong arms and legs as well. I just went face first into the water when the boat sped up. And it wasn't somewhere warm like this. It's the Straits of Menai, northwest coast of Wales. Went face first into the water. Yeah, Jebel Ali. Tried it twice. It was a school trip. Tried it twice. I said, look, just get me out of the water. So my chemistry teacher was in the boat. Chemistry teacher. So we did cross-country running at school. She said, no, stay in the water, try again. I said, nah, get me out of here. Yeah. So I failed water skiing. It's actually more difficult than it looks. Just go face first into the water when the boat speeds up. Yeah, Jebel Ali. And the hotel. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Right, just over here there's a sign, the main entrance of the hotel. I'll show you that and then we'll cut the video. Thanks for watching, folks. I like this hotel, it's alright. It's on the outer front of the Palm in Dubai. So not bad from that point of view. I think it's a nightclub, I didn't go there because like I told you, supper club. Supper club sounds like a nightclub. I didn't go there because I got off the plane and 7 hours from Singapore, all that kind of stuff, you know, day one of holiday, supper club, too tired, etc. So I was just walking on the outer front of the Palm, that's what it looks like, yeah? Well, I heard about it. That's actually what it looks like. Series of semicircular arcs. It's all built on reclaimed land. Yeah, the hotel sign's just here. I just want to show you that. Supper club. The hotel. Just here on the right. So that's, I think that's called Emerald Palace Hotel. I told you, this outer front, it's all five-star hotels. Next along the street, because you drive past it when you come here. Taj Exotic are building one. W are building one. Atlantis, the Palm, have already got one. All right, so that's the place. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray in Dubai. So thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Going to Abu Dhabi this afternoon. J for Jumeirah. All right, ciao. That's the Atlantis, the Palm Hotel. It's on the outer front at the Palm in Dubai. As is this hotel, welcome to the Jumeirah Zabeel Saray Hotel. It's the view from my room, looking at the Palm in Dubai. Beautiful Sunday morning here. So welcome to Dubai, people, and welcome to the Jumeirah Hotel in Dubai. Yeah, I'll give you a tour of the place. Yeah, so that's the Atlantis Palm. I've stayed there before. That's on the center of the outer front. Palm. Those people that are familiar with what the Palm is. See all these expensive houses. I think there's 8 fronts to the Palm. David Beckham's got a house there. The Emirate of Dubai. The beautiful blue waters. Beautiful Sunday morning. Persian Arabian Gulf here in Dubai. It's the view from the room. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Hotel has its own private beach, which is just there. If you notice, all the chairs face this way and not the water's way. We'll walk down there, I'll show you that. Which is fair enough, because looking at the hotel down there is actually much nicer than looking out to the water. It's a beautiful view. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray Hotel. Hotels also residences. They're quite expensive, the residences. So there's buildings there. Yeah, so on the outer front of the Palm. It's a view from the room. Garden needs a bit of work. It's all right. Get a decent view of the Palm. The Burj Al Arab, it's the most famous hotel. Dubai city center. It's basically in that direction. We're in the Emirate of Dubai. Jebel Ali is the suburb. Just sort of over there. Past the residences. Alrighty. So, Rumi, you got a balcony? I think it's some deluxe king palm room. Palm view room. It's the palm there. There's one up from the basic room. This is the room that you get here. Jumeirah on home turf. Jumeirah is a hotel chain. And the first one was the Burj and the Jumeirah Beach Hotel. And then got a few around the world and one or two in Dubai as well. The UAE. It's a room. It's a good room. It's a good hotel. Yeah, that's the place, Jumeirah. So we'll just orientate ourselves. Just orientate ourselves to where we are. So I've got my handy iPhone. We'll go on Google Maps. Yeah, so that's the place. Yeah, we're on the outer palm now. We'll just... Yeah, that's the one. So that's the palm in Dubai. That's what it looks like, yeah. That blue dot is me just there. When it zooms, it says the Palm Jumeirah. Yep. Atlantis Palm, the hotel that you saw out there. Just make it a bit smaller. Dubai. Straits of Hormuz, Iran. Make it a bit smaller. And you can still see the blue dot. That's where I am. It's Africa, Europe, the Americas, it's around the world, yeah. Antarctica and so on. MH370 is down there somewhere. Alrighty. So that's where we are. Welcome to Dubai. Welcome to the Jumeirah Hotel in Dubai, yeah. Alrighty. So Atlantis the Palm, I've stayed there before, which is why I'm not staying there today. It's out of front, the inner ones have all got houses. The outer ones are, I think it's for 5-star hotels. Look at some of these houses. It's about $2 or $3 million US for a house, maybe a bit more. Nice houses, yeah? I think there's 8 fronts. This is the most outer one. I'll talk to you about the hotels that are on the fronts later. Let's go on our walk. Balcony. Towel as always for the heat. And this is the room that you get here. Yeah, we got it yesterday. Some fruit there. That's where the room's been used for a day. This is that's their spa. Tali's Ottoman spa. The whole hotel is built on the theme of the Turkish Ottoman Empire. Vision, this is like a Dubai magazine. Stuff about Dubai. They keep reinventing themselves every year. That's the Jumeirah magazine. Yeah, it's all adverts for stuff like that. Best Middle Eastern restaurant, according to BBC. And we've got BBC on the box. Because it's also the best broadcasting service in the world. Yeah, that's the room. Yeah, it's one off the basic room. I wanted a palm view because I think it's better than looking at the open ocean. I'll walk you to both sides. And we get there. Right, what else did I want to show you here? Alright, so look at the bathroom. It's just right here. Okay, sports fans. Yeah, the gear is Asprey London. Good old quality British stuff. Yeah, it's a room. The bathroom is quite a large bathtub actually. I read a review on Twitter for the, you can see through to the bedroom. I read a review on Twitter. Somebody wrote, you can actually go swimming in it. Yeah, if you really want to. That's the shower. Yeah, we're not going to waste unnecessary time here, but sure, the minibar. It's always very important. Fully stocked, no alcohol, because we're in the Middle East. Muslim country. Oh, there is. Yeah, you can get alcohol in 5-star hotels here. You can't get it, like... you can't just go to a shopping mall or walk down the street to a pub. And, you go to a pub and stuff, but, 5-star hotels is okay. A little bit smart like that. Alright, so that's the palm. We'll go for a walk. Yeah, I normally try and make videos on the first day I get here so it doesn't look like this. You know, the bed looks nice. You know what you're getting yourself in for when you check into a hotel. We got in at Emirates garden with the
boys.
Bathroom, nice. Ottoman styling. Yeah, we got in at Emirates yesterday at, we were supposed to get in at 1 o'clock. We actually got in at 5 o'clock, please.
My man.
2 and 8. Yeah, we got in at, plane was supposed to get in at 1 o'clock. We're going at 1:30. Got a total about 3 o'clock. I'd booked to go and do some sightseeing in Dubai Mall. Took the boat on the fountain, went up Burj Khalifa up at the top. 6 o'clock. Basically dumped the stuff here and went sightseeing straight away. So that's why I get the hotel video on day two. So this hotel, Jumeirah Zabeel Saray, it's, they say it's all sort of based on Ottoman Turkish Empire design. The Ottoman Empire was went on for about 7 centuries between like, I don't know, 11th to the 18th or something. Yeah, so that's the main thoroughfare from the lobby. Yeah, the Ottoman Empire went until, they say it united the Muslim community all the way from Turkey, the Middle East, North Africa and stuff. And when you're in a Muslim country, I think it's fair enough to design a hotel as such. That's not the reason I stay here, because I'm not Muslim. I think it's a perfectly decent religion. I stay here because it's Jumeirah at the beach. Just working my way down the list. All right, we'll go downstairs to the mezzanine. Yeah, there's your Ottoman design. It's a good hotel. I wouldn't say it's a great hotel. I think it's a good hotel. All right, we'll go to mezzanine. Yeah, I'm on level 2. That's one of the basic room. Yeah, that's the main walkway from the lobby. It's a nice hotel. Jumeirah, stay different. That's the spa. Apparently it's the largest spa. When we checked in, they said it's the largest spa in the Middle East and Africa. Shops, shops on both sides. That's the main entrance, the centre bit where you see that waterfall. Today is December the 14th, so Christmas is just around the corner. They've got a big Christmas tree in the middle. In a Muslim country, it's lovely to see. We'll walk along there in a bit. Al Dukan, the business centre is just up here. It's just down there, the business centre. Wait for the order full sketch up, yep. Business centre is just over there. There's no point walking down there. I walked down there earlier, it's a dead end. Yeah, we'll just walk along the mezzanine because you get good views of the main lobby area. You can see all the shops down there. I think that's a Lebanese restaurant. Lebanese, Al Nufura. The reflection of a Rodeo Drive. It's the main lobby. Let's walk along there. Yeah, it's a good hotel. I like it. It's good. It's not the best in Dubai. It's not the best in the world, but it's a nice hotel. Yeah, it's just the main lobby complex. The main entrance of the hotel is just to the left there. You can make out the light Christmas tree. 11 days from Christmas. Main lobby. Reindeer. Santa Claus. Wait, there, Santa Claus on his reindeer. And a Christmas tree and a fountain. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Zabeel Saray. That's the bar, 3 o'clock in the morning. I went there about midnight last night, and people sitting out, it's quite full actually, people sitting out, they're smoking that hashish stuff. Yeah, Sunday morning here, it's just after 10 o'clock in the morning, right yesterday. It's a bit quiet in the morning. Yeah, you check in just over there on the right. It's a bit there. It's a Christmas theme in Dubai.
Just walk along the mezzanine floor to the end. We'll walk down the stairs. I'll walk you along that walkway.
It's nice. Not every hotel in the world is the same. Service is pretty good. They're fairly prompt when you ask them for a bucket of ice, can you come and clean the bins? When you order food that's not on the room service menu, and so on. Like prawn curry is not on the room service menu, but if you want prawn curry, they'll make it for you. Yes, that's the main fountain in the middle. Walk down there. How do you say it? Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. All right, I remember that. Zabeel Saray. Yeah, just walk on this corridor. Walk the end and then cut down, take the stairs down. There's various meeting rooms here. Turquoise meeting. So on. There's another restaurant there. Diamond. Alrighty, show you the hotel key card. Looks like that on the one side. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Sarah, whatever it be. Alright, so that looks like a steakhouse. Another Christmas tree. It's called the Rib Room. I think it's a steakhouse. Alrighty. Let's go. Stairs down. Let's go to the main lobby. Shops here. There's a restaurant as well. One's called, well, that's the Voda Bar. That one's open till like 3 o'clock in the morning. It's a beach access through there. Christmas decorations. Wonderful. I was walking to the lobby, the main bit, center bit, four shops. So this is the fountain in the middle. It's the fountain in the middle of the entrance. Just there. Checkout is just over there. That's what we'll be doing later today because we're going to Abu Dhabi this afternoon. Taking the seaplane. Yeah, that's the main entrance. Checkout is the fountain. It's your Christmas tree in a Muslim country. Very good. Santa Claus and his reindeer. Let's walk to this bar. Yeah, it's lobby bar. This way you check in. Straight there. Welcome to Dubai. I think it's the world's fastest growing city. Let's check out. So you saw all this from the mezzanine floor upstairs? They say it's Turkish Ottoman design. If I didn't know that, I wouldn't realize, yeah? I would just think it's just another hotel. You know, you can design it how the heck you want to, I don't care. As long as it's nice. Decent food, decent bed, safe. Good location, that's all that matters. All right, we'll go to the beach. The beach is... Hi. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Yep. Thank you, thank you. It's the wrong card. Yeah, security, it's good. All right. I don't know if you realize, I just half dropped the camera there. All right, we're back to head up display. Alrighty. So just walked outside, it's beachside in the hotel. Saw this from the room. Absolutely beautiful, yeah? It's gorgeous. I forgot to put a towel on the balcony so it could identify my room. The gardens. The rest of the hotel. Absolutely great. I think, at a guess, that's my room. That one there. I walk to the beach. I walk over the pool. That's the hotel, Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Palm in Dubai.
So we'll walk down to the beach, go past the pool, and check out the place.
That's the all the dining areas at the hotel. Just a little pool here. Beautiful, yeah. It's like an infinity pool at the Palm. It's my mum there. Hello. Yeah, she's sitting in the cafe, cappuccino. It's the bridge. It's in the gardens of the hotel. Nice pool. Yeah, it's a different design, yeah, but it's still nice. I won't knock it. Walk down to the beachside. The kids' play area just over there. See all those green and yellow colours? It's for kids. A little water sports and stuff. Shallow pools so they don't drown. Hey.
Morning.
Morning. It's called Palm Jumeirah. It's beachside dining area. Right. Now, one interesting thing you'll see here is all the deck chairs face the hotel. None of them face the water. The hotel obviously has a self-inflated opinion of itself. And people don't even turn the chairs the other way. They just look at the hotel and not the water. When in Rome, I'm not complaining. All right, so this is the Palm. The Palm in Dubai. You saw that on the Google Maps. You've got Atlantis, the Palm is just out there. That's on the right at the center. And then there's, I think there's 8 fronts. You see the houses on each of the fronts there? We're on the west front. West front, the hotel is this Kempinski on this side. You have to drive, when you come here, you have to drive all the way along the center one and you drive all the way around the loop, so it's a bit of a drive. There's a Kempinski there. They're building a W hotel. I think that might be Kempinski's next further along. That might be Kempinski. They're building a W hotel and a Taj Exotica on this side. We're at the Jumeirah. There's also a one and only, the one and only hotel chain, also five star. They're further along the coast. On the east, this is the outer front, yeah? On the other side, it's the east side, it's the west side. So the west side, this side is Kempinski, they're building W, Taj, Jumeirah, one and only. On the west side, on the east side, it's the other side. There's a Sofitel, Anantara, Waldorf Astoria, off the top of my head. Let's go and look at the water. Persian Arabian Gulf. I'm wearing shoes. Alright, get it wet. Screw it up. It's not a proper beach anyway, because it's man-made and inland. Socks are gone now. Alright, so we'll go back inside. Walk out the front. We'll go back inside. Walk out the front. I'll show the... So mine's a palm view room. You can also get an ocean view room. It's on the other side, so I'll show you that. Section of ocean. Because it's the... It's the Straits of Hormuz. Could you see the top of the birds there? It's the Burj Al Arab. And the Burj Khalifa. Excellent, I don't think I'd see that. Burj Al Arab, Burj Khalifa in one frame. Went up the Burj Khalifa yesterday. At night, it's quite good. That's the hotel in the infinity pool. Walked over the bridge. Nice Sunday morning. Nice walk on a Sunday morning. People sunbathing, looking at the hotel. I've never seen that before. All right, that is the first ever for me. Yeah. Yeah, the Jumeirah residence is just further along. I think they start at like 10, yeah, they call it Royal Residences. It's that one there. I looked at the photos when I booked this hotel. I thought I'd stay there for a night. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. Stay different. I looked at the prices, yeah, it's like 10,000 dirhams for a night. Conversion rate to UK pounds is 5.6. It's like 2 grand a night. That Burj Al Arab is about just over 1,000, but it's nice. Yeah, let's walk into the gardens, walk back in the hotel, and I'll take you out the front. Leisure counter. Yeah. Towels for the swimming and stuff. That's the bridge we walked over earlier. Saw the pool to the right. Yeah, it's good. It's a good hotel. Not the best in the world. Not the best in Dubai. But it's good. You don't stay in the same place all the time, right? You want to check out different places. It's part of exploring the planet. Dining area. Just walk back into the hotel. Cut out the front. Let's get the camera on me as we walk past security here. Walk outside. Go at the other side, look at ocean view. Yeah. Hope you like my shirt. When you're on holiday, you know, you get random shirts. Batik, I think they call it. Lobby, Christmas tree, fountain. Best story I have about shirts. I'll tell you in a minute. That's the main lobby. Just going to walk out the front. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Let's walk out the front. So this is the front entrance. Jumeirah Zabeel Saray. You can say it right now. Got these fountains out here. On both sides. Very nice, grand entrance to the hotel. The Christmas tree. That's the main entrance. You see a reflection of me. Good day, boys. Hi. Yeah, that's how you get here. Right, so we'll
walk the beach there. So that story about shirts, yeah? When you're on holiday, you wear silly shirts like this, yeah?
Hi, hi. Just walking around. Yeah, it's the main entrance. First time ever I went to the Maldives, I got in about, it was a late night, late evening flight, going about 10 o'clock in the evening. Speedboat comes to pick you up. So I was just wearing normal clothes, like shorts and a t-shirt. Got in the speedboat, takes to the resort. It was Paradise Island or something, about 20 minutes from the airport. There's an American guy, he got on as well. He was wearing like normal, he was wearing trousers and a like a business shirt. I think he just got off a long haul flight. Sat in front of me on the boat and said, he put on this short sleeve shirt with like big dolphins on it. Said, yeehaw, I'm back in the Maldives. So that's what you do on your holiday, yeah? You wear silly shirts. It's the main entrance. That's Jebel Ali.